excitement in St. Charles.
Two days after the mayoral election and still no winner. The St. Charles mayoral election was supposed to be pretty simple.
Yeah, choose between the incumbent and the challenger. But as Amanda Lewis shows us, this story has twist after twist after twist. Amanda?
Well, Kevin, after months of campaigning, it's a result that has the incumbent mayor asking why they bothered with an election at all.
In St. Charles, Iowa, 224 people did their civic duty on Tuesday night. In this small church on Main Street, they voted. 2 days later, they still have no idea who will be mayor.
Excitement in St. Charles. We don't get that often. This is pretty exciting for us.
After what appeared to be a hard-fought campaign with dueling yard signs and dueling supporters.
I voted for Joanne. I think she's done some great things for the community.
And Smith. Yeah. Just because they're pretty much associated with the Cub Scouts and stuff around here.
Joanne Brown and Dennis Smith are neck and neck. 112 votes for Brown, 111 for Smith. That was until this afternoon.
We, Luella,
Joanne,
Kathleen,
do solemnly swear.
One group of Madison County election officials take one carefully kept absentee ballot out of the county lockbox and open it.
The vote is for Dennis Smith.
Now it's a tie.
Isn't that interesting?
It is, when you consider the uncounted St. Charles ballots in Madison County Auditor Joan Welch's hand.
There are two of them that's in here marked as spoiled.
There are a couple of things that can spoil a ballot. The voter can mess up and ask for a fresh ballot. The discarded ballot is spoiled.
Another spoiled ballot could be, say they filled out all the stuff and then they signed their name to it. I mean, that spoils that ballot.
In either case, spoiled ballots are never counted.
I have no idea what it is, but we'll never get to see them. Even in a recount, we will not see it.
So the mystery will remain, and the St. Charles mayor's race will be decided the old-fashioned way.
What they did was put a name in a hat, and they drew out a name, is what they did.
And that's exactly what they'll do next Tuesday. I talked to incumbent Mayor Joanne Brown this afternoon. She said if they were going to pull a name out of a hat, they should have done that before the election. And I was unable to reach her challenger, Dennis Smith, for comment.
Yeah, Kevin. Pulling it out of the hat may seem strange, but that's the way it's done. It's been done before. But what about a recount?
Well, the auditor's office, they say they can recount legitimate ballots, but it's not automatic. Someone would have to request it.
All right. Amanda, thank you very much. Very interesting.